going to be jamming. We're going to be jamming. We have decided again. Many people say to me, we love those music shows. Bring us more of those. We were so happy when Jonathan Butler, our own son, I'm going to put it that way, decided, yes, I want to sing to the people of South Africa who are not able to attend the concert. And that's what we're going to be doing here tonight. And we're featuring him with some of the international artists that are in this country right now. So stay tuned and just have a great evening. Our first artist tonight is none other than British singer. I like his name, Omar. Do you like that, Omar? Yeah. We're going to be talking to Omar after this, but let's hear what he's going to do. Let's hear his stuff. Omar.
Too late to
Singer. Why do they call you British singer?
Because I'm from England.
You were born in England?
Yeah, London.
And you have young South African musicians that are backing you.
Very good.
What do you think of the talent in this country?
Very good. I like the way everybody dances over here.
Oh,
everybody's
yeah.
got rhythm, so it's a nice place to come.
Yeah, hey, Africa, everybody has rhythm in Africa, you know that.
Especially here, though.
But tell me, 5 albums you've already produced.
Mm-hmm.
What inspired you into getting into this?
Listening to people like Stevie Wonder, Bob Marley, people like them, you know, just inspired me to create music like this now. And plus, my grandmother was from Cuba, so I like Latin music, you know, so this is what I do now.
Mm-hmm. I saw my sister dancing like crazy there because she loves that Latin tang yeah. to it. Twang,
it's kind of sexy,
say.
Isn't it?
It is sexy, yeah. yeah.
You're kind I of mean, sexy
you,
too.
Oh, thank you, darling. Oh, thank you, darling. Oh my God, you just...
Give me a phone number after this.
Phone number, we'll talk after this. Okay. Give him a hand. Thanks so much. Before you go, Oma, let's hear from the people out here. First, let me find out about this concert and the fund. What are we trying to do? Why did we bring all these international artists to perform in South Africa?
Felicia, the Nations Trust was established in 1995 when the Queen came on her first state visit, and she and the President are patrons. And the Trust is trying to raise the profile of youth and their plight in this country in terms of unemployment.
That's why we've invited youth primarily, by the way, for this show. It's again just a continuation of the Two Nations concert in studio.
Right. So we give loans of between 500 and 5,000 rands to young unemployed people with a business idea. We are also, as the Nations Trust, modelled on the Prince's Trust in the UK. And next to me is the director of the Prince's Trust, Tom Shabir.
You want to tell us more about the Prince Fund?
Well, the Prince's Trust, we've been going for 21 years. We're a big institution in Britain. We've created
it's tens Prince of... Prince Charles is here, isn't
it's Prince it? Charles. It's Prince Charles. He's just over there, but he's too modest to speak to.
All right, okay. So you can
I'm the spokesman.
All right,
there
okay.
We started it 21 years ago. It's become a big institution in Britain. It creates tens of thousands of jobs. People have admired it. Some South Africans admired it and thought that there was something that would be learned and we could bring here. And we started raising some money, got it underway. Mm-hmm. And now there's a whole collaborative venture going on because those young people there, they're not all South Africans, actually. Mm-hmm. They're Brits and they're South Africans.
Hey, where are the Brits? Surprise can you. The Brits raise their hands? Let me see
there
the Brits.
There you are. Rather a lot of Brits.
Wow.
And you can't tell, and they're
no,
doing
you
it together.
Tell. Uh-huh.
And this was a great South African idea when mm-hmm. President Mandela came to London. On a state visit last July, mm-hmm. and he asked that instead of the normal formality of a great state occasion, you know, behind closed doors, mm-hmm. why don't we do a big celebration for people? So we hired what he called that great round building in London.
So how does it benefit South African youth?
In that event, it was a fantastic great occasion with the Queen and Mandela and the whole of the royal family, 6,000 people. It raised £400,000.
Mm-hmm.
How much is that? Times 8, is it now?
Yes, yeah.
Bit of a sensitive subject,
don't
I never
about that.
Times however much that is. Quite a few millions of rands, all to be spent on this project, creating jobs in South Africa.
Mm. And, yeah. New job. I applauded that because they say unemployment is literally 45% in this country. So that's why I do.
One thing you can do is create work for yourself. Create your small micro enterprise, which makes you employable by you. Mm-hmm. And then, if you're lucky, and you're good at it, and a lot of people are good at it, help you to employ other people. And that creates jobs. We've created 60,000 jobs in 10 years, just like that, many other things we do, just like that in Britain, and you can do the same here. And we take only those people who the banks won't help. We take a lot of risks, we help people, give them a mentor, and they can succeed. And there's a lot of successful people here in the studio, I think, and many more out there.
Stay tuned, because after the break, we're going to talk to South Africa's only son, one of South Africa's only sons, I should say, Jonathan Butler. We want to find out how he makes it overseas and really makes a great name for South Africa.
You know, when they introduce me on stage everywhere, and they say, from Cape Town, South Africa, Jonathan Butler, it's the most proud, that's the proud moment for me.
Excited. South Africa's prodigal son. I'm going to call him a prodigal son, and he has to tell me why they call him the prodigal son. I guess he goes and comes back, gets nostalgic. I'm talking about Jonathan Butler. Well, we want to hear what you have to bring back home, but I want to talk to you after this. Stay tuned, folks. Let's hear your first one. It's Heal Our Land.
Yeah!
that song obviously is talking about South Africa.
Yeah, and it's talking also about the prodigal son, me. It really started. I wanted to really talk about, you know, South Africa in the music, because for years people were asking me, when are you going to write something about South Africa and not love songs? And so I said, well, I'm a hopeless romantic, but you know, there is going to come a time that I will write something about South Africa and just my experience as a child growing up here.
I mean, you call it the land of opportunity, which it is, and I think most of us don't see it.
Yeah.
Our concern is the crime.
Yeah.
People like you have lived abroad and you come home and you see this beautiful land of opportunity just literally going to waste.
Well, you know, everything, the reason for my success and for my opportunities is really God. It's really God. And because before the opportunity came, I was a 14 years old drug addict till I was 19 or 20 years old. And I was largely famous as a child here. I mean, I'm playing in front of my families here. So Christ, you know, the Lord has really been the reason for the opportunities. And it's there every day. Maybe the focus just needs to shift about crime. And sometimes people focus so much on the crime and other things and forget that the opportunities are really there every day, you know.
You know, you touched. You touched on something that is so important, drugs and young people.
Yeah.
And you are a role model, obviously. Help us help those young people out there. We go back to the various neighborhoods from Soweto to Cape Town to Guguletu to Kwamashu, wherever.
Yeah.
Drugs seem to be a major concern.
Well, since I've come home, you know, I got involved with a program called Head Start in Cape Town. And it's really focusing on the youth and drugs and the Cape Flats. And I understand. I mean, I understand. I didn't know. I thought, you know, peer pressure. I was involved with Ronnie Joyce and Colin Ricketts and Cecil Mitchell and Richard John Smith. And I started messing around with marijuana. And then from there, it went to Mandrax. And before I knew it, I was broke. I was sinking down in the pit of hell. And I guess what I want to say to the young people is don't do drugs. It's not smart. It's a trap. It's a deceiving. It's very deceiving, and it's a lonely place, you know. And there are people that you idolize that don't do drugs, and music is so much better without it. So,
I tell you, you know, I'm looking at you. I cannot believe what you've just said, and that you've come out of it.
Yeah.
And I'm sure young people out there now saying, "I can get out of it." In fact, I'd like to talk to young people out there who want to come here and say, "I want to get out of it. Help me, Felicia. How do I get out of it?" We're going to call in counselors to come and talk to you and counsel you right here on air.
Yeah.
But how did you manage? You know, you broke what I call a norm.
Yeah.
People say you cannot go to America and sing the American songs because you're competing against the Teddies, the Luthers, and no way. But you did it.
You have to make a commitment. And when you leave, complete the work that you've set out to do. That's the important thing. And when I got the opportunity to go to England, I realized that, you know, God has gave me this wonderful opportunity. And part of me wanted to come back home. Every month I wanted to come back home. But it's staying committed and making a decision. I'm going to pursue the goals before me. And the Luthers and the Al Jarreaus, it doesn't matter, you know. And it's wonderful that, you know, God has brought me in the companies of such great people as well
Number of shows I've seen, obviously, of you abroad, and obviously your opening act with Whitney Houston.
Yeah, yeah.
And people stood and they said, "That's a South African boy." People don't forget that. Do you stress that South African thing?
It's the, you know, when they introduce me on stage everywhere, and they say, "From Cape Town, South Africa, Jonathan Butler." It's the most proud, that's the proud moment for me, because I feel like I'm sort of, you know, I don't know, representing everyone here. Everyone.
40 million people.
40 million people,
40
you
million
know,
people.
And it's a proud feeling.
Tell me about this blonde look.
This is, I don't know, you know, I went to the hairdresser one day, because I'm naturally gray, born gray, I mean, not born gray, but I mean, and I told the hairdressing guy, I said, "Listen, you know, do something with my hair, because I don't want to dye it black, you know, because it looks silly when I dye my hair black." So he said, "You know, how about going blonde?" And I said, yeah, I don't mind going blonde, you know, but my children, my daughter's 13 years old and my baby daughter, she's 9. And my wife said, you're going to have to go pick them up at school. So I'm in the car, and I get to the school, and my daughter's like, wow, you know, grabbed my hand and led me to all her friends. Check my dad out. Doesn't he look cool? He looks fresh, you know.
Oh, that's cute.
So I got the approval from my kids, you know. So. But it's good to do something radical sometimes, you know.
That's true. Jonathan, can you give us one more? And then I know you have to leave.
Okay.
What are you going to give us?
I don't know. Let me see.
What do you want?
Down on my knees.
Down on my knees, they say.
Really?
There's some song here that I got curious about. Song for Elizabeth. Who be Elizabeth?
Elizabeth is my mother. You know, she had 17 kids, and so I kind of wrote a song for her.
Okay. Lost to Love. Who's that? What's that about?
Lost to Love. As a matter of fact, that was a wonderful opportunity. I wrote with. I met Lulu and her brother from England in Los Angeles. We had sushi together, and she said,
"You eat sushi?
I eat sushi.
Boy, I tell you, you have become Americanized.
I eat sushi.
Once you pop and flay, see so young.
I can't pop and steak. I love my sushi.
Okay, let's hear it.
I was going to play this for you guys. Okay, now I'll play that. Now I'll play I'm on My Knees. Okay, we'll do a little medley here. Oh no, all right, well, I don't know. Okay, I'll give you another verse. That's the second verse, now I'll sing the other song.
Said he comes originally for hails originally from Cape Town. Our next group is from Cape Town, one of my favorite groups, the Rockets. Stay tuned. Hello here to the Rockets.
Africa, what a man. We'll be right back.
get it together. Cause we're having a party.
When did the group start and why did it start? Was it any influence from the Kuhn Festival, Kuhn Carnival Festival?
Yeah, well, a lot of our musicians in Cape Town originate from the Kuhn Carnival because that's where it starts. And every year we have this big celebration. And I started there and all of these guys.
Now, what's the next song you're going to hit?
We took a lot of the old love songs, you know. Mm-hmm. In Cape Town, it's a kind of dance that the people like to do, which they call jazz. I don't know if you've seen
it. Oh, yeah, I can it, young. So, I know that. Somehow I got into it one day.
So what we did was we took a lot of love songs and we put them into a jazz, as you call a jazz groove, you know.
Let's hear it.
Stay so young. Bar.
Something I hate to do.
Why do we need the Manhattans? Why do we need Luther Vandross? Why do we? No, we do though. We do. Kind of add variety, the spice of life. What did you think of them?
Wow.
Wow. You see, they say good things come to those who wait, but great things come to those who hustle. After the break, we'll continue. Thanks to the Rockets.
You know, I didn't even think about the competition. I just thought there was something I wanted to do. And I didn't look upon anything with a view of there being barriers. Mm-hmm. I just went in there and thought, I want to do things.
I just heard something funny here. What is the translation of Felicia Mabuza's subtle show?
The translation of Felicia Mabuza show, KaSiZulu. UFelicia uyabuza, shut up.
Oh boy, only in South Africa would you come up with those, boy. But our next artist hails from Guguletu in Cape Town. What is this about Cape Town? Everybody who sings well comes out of Cape Town. And he has done session work with big names. Simply Red, Teddy Pendergrass, Yuma Sikela, and Kaifa Semenya. The first time I saw him was at the Miss South Africa show. I must admit it was the first time I'd kind of heard of Ringo. And I was like, huh? Is he from here? They said, no, he's from overseas. They said, no, he is one of our boys. Let's hear what he has to say. He's giving us something local. Singing Sondela.
Long.
Talk to Ringo. Boy, it's Ringo. What a pity I'm 29 and you're older than me. When did it start?
As long as I remember, I started realizing that I was a singer when I started seeing things around me. Then I would start singing about whatever.
What a vibe in the studio. And guess what? I'm going to talk to another South African artist who is making a name for South Africa overseas. Trevor Rabin, formerly from the group Rabbit, is making a name for this country and saying, hey, recognize we also have talent. Bring me Trevor in and bring me some bar stools. Let's sit right here. You know, this guy here, he says, if I, he thought I was lying, you're not here. He said, if he's not here, I'm going to toy toy. You know what a toy toy is?
Two toys.
Trevor, 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 Trevor. You've been gone from home too long, honey. You got to get back. Who knows how to toy toy? Hey, anyway, show what's a toy toy? Toy toying is when we throw a tantrum. It's called an African tantrum.
I can do that.
Toy toy there. Can someone toy toy? Hey, 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 hey. That's it. Okay. That's it. Thank you, guys. It means, boy, they're about to raise hell. Okay. I was just impressed that he's white and he says he's going to toy toy.
Okay. I'd like to see you do it, actually.
Welcome home.
Thank you very much.
And how is it being overseas?
It's great. It's been a long... I left in 78, so I've been gone a long time.
That is a long time.
And I'm only 22, so...
I'm 29.
Yeah. You don't look a day older than 24.
You know what? That's why I told them they have to get you here, because you had to get that plug in for me. And your music overseas. Yeah. Was it difficult to compete there?
You know, I didn't even think about the competition. I just thought there was something I wanted to do. And I didn't look upon anything with a view of there being barriers. Mm-hmm. I just went in there and thought, I want to do things. And I didn't feel intimidated by anything. I felt inspired by things that might be competitive or things that might be difficult to overcome.
Great hits, though, that you've come up with.
Yeah.
Your favorite one of the many?
Well, I think Owner of a Lonely Heart's probably the one that will...
Well, how does it go?
Dong, gong, gong, dong, gong, kakadong, gong.
And then?
Move yourself along. You always live your life. Owner of a lonely heart.
Yeah, boy, Trevor!
There's a choir. Those guys were unbelievable.
We're going to hear them. We're going to be hearing them.
Unbelievable.
I wish you could hear them with you. What do you do with them? Which one is the one you do? That's the one. Yeah. That's why you guys had all that vibe there. I missed the concert, but I tell you what, that's why we're continuing it right here in studio. Great. But your message to South Africans?
Which ones?
The
young ones?
Let's start off with the young ones, because that's what is important now.
Just that there's a great future, and to reach out for your dreams and go all the way. Don't be restricted by anything. Just reach for the stars.
In fact, that's why I wanted to hear why this gentleman really wanted to hear you. Can you take the mic and talk?
Well, I've been a big fan of Trevor since Rabbit's days. And what I wanted to know is, apart from your influences from Clapton, I read that you idolized Clapton. Were there any other major influences like Hendrix or...?
Clapton was a very early influence. And before then, Hank B. Marvin. But there were a lot of guys that I really loved, Hendrix obviously being one, which I really loved, and John McLaughlin was another one. And you know, there's so many great players, and you steal a little bit from all of them and put together your own thing.
Well, you talked about the young people, mm-hmm. and I really thank you for taking the time to come and talk to the folk in your land.
Well,
when are you coming home? We need you home.
Well, I try and come home...
No, I'm talking about living here. You know, I was also living overseas for the last 20 years, and I came back. You can come back.
Oh, that makes me feel guilty.
No,
I have a 12-year-old son who's very, very much American, has his friends there. So I think he would be a little bit unhappy.
I had a 12-year-old daughter I brought back, and she was happy. I'm not trying to make you guilty, but I appreciate what you're doing. I think the need to spread South African music, mm-hmm. South African talent overseas mm-hmm. is also crucial.
I wanted very much to play at the Two Nations gig, mm-hmm. and we had to put a band together. And they put a band together with South African musicians who were just incredible. Lorraine Shannon, Danny Lillooet, Kevin Kruger, mm-hmm. Johan Lars. And I came in, and after 2 days, they played like we've been playing together for 3 weeks.
We're going to hear some of the young people who backed you.
Yes.
Okay, let's hear them.
Sorry.
Yeah.
The choir were incredible. just great as well. And, you know, it was just an amazing experience. The only person that made mistakes was me.
That's what you get for being a professional. But again, thanks, Trevor, for visiting with us and talking to the people of South Africa.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Before I call the choir down, I'd like to thank Joy, Trevor's mom, for telling Trevor that this is the best show to be on television. And thanks for being one of our number one fans, Joy. You know what's good. Now we're going to call down the choir, but as they come down, could you tell us a little bit more about the choir? Could you come down this way, please?
Felicia, the Two Nations Youth Collaboration Choir were originally 50 young people, 25 from South Africa, Western Cape, KwaZulu-Natal, and Gauteng, and the other 25 came from all over the United Kingdom. They were tutored by the Prince Charles Rock School in London and also by the Pell Mama Assembly in Soweto. They met 1 week before the concert and rehearsed at Sun City under the auspices of Sun International. And they performed at the concert after 1 week's rehearsal together.
Wow.
That is real talent.
The taller I become, the further you take my rights away, the faster I will run. You can deny me, you can decide to turn your face away. No matter what, something inside so strong, I know.
makes you come into the UK? That's what I want to know.
Felicia, you are a bad girl. We need you in England. You're bad, man. It's been great being on the show. It's been really exciting seeing everybody perform and being able to perform myself. It's been wicked.
Yeah.
I think the whole experience was very amazing. We've learned so much and we can't wait to go back to the UK and bring back all the culture that we've picked up over the last couple of weeks.
Ava is a great show. We had a wonderful time performing on it. The audience is really nice and Felicia's excellent. When are you going to come to the UK?
Season's greetings, South Africa, and to all our viewers out there who have made this their number one talk show, we thank you and would like to say to you, have a prosperous new year.